What is the most inoffensive thing you've seen someone get offended by? One of my coworkers was surprised and said, "Oh my God." A religious coworker overheard her using God's name in vain and reported it to ours. They had to have meetings with ours and the managers about respecting people's religion. The lady said, "Oh my God," she didn't wish for the death of Christianity for frick's sake. It was ridiculous. The Canadian flag. Told me that if they put up a Canadian flag in PA, the neighbors would come and shoot everybody. Not quite sure about the logic on that one. Some people are weird when it comes to flags. I live in a mostly Hispanic part of New York. You can't drive by a house without seeing a Puerto Rican flag or a few American ones. One time a Nation family moved here and put up a flag that had Buddha on it. A bunch of people beached and Buddha was taken down. Apparently Buddha is racist. The guy who got offended in a council meeting because someone used the term black hole. Edit. Found a video. Yow2.be web link. That was John Willie Price, a longtime Dallas City Council member. If I remember correctly, they were asking him why all the paperwork in his department kept disappearing. So he starts throwing a fit about why does everything bad have to be black, like black sheep, devil's food cake, etc. And of course he never did answer where all the paperwork was going. Time to tear down the statues of Stephen Hawking. I didn't know there were any statues of Stephen Hawking still standing. When I worked in customer service, yes ma'am. Don't you ma'am me. Don't you fucking ma'am me, you piece of shit. Okay, sir. At my wedding we marked the vegetarian items as vegetarian. This made the one vegetarian at my wedding, sister-in-law who hates me, fly into a catatonic rage, because we are singling out the vegetarian food as vegetarian, and not treating it as normal food. Then how the frick are they supposed to know it's vegetarian? I sang the song Hit the Road Jack to a kid I just beat in a game, while in the third grade mockingly. He took that as me calling him a jackass. He told the recess monitor this. I was told to stand against a wall away from the rest of the kids with the recess monitor. I'm now 27 now, married with two kids, but I will never forget this. If you ever see this, I didn't call you a jackass Jard, but now, fuck you forever. Edit. Thank you all, and I'm sorry to hear a lot of you had Jeds too. First comment of mine to get really any response, much less gold or awards. I had a coworker who got mad at me because I asked her not to tickle me. That's inappropriate at work. B. We are not children. We are not in a relationship. We are not family. C. I don't like being tickled. She flipped out and said everyone likes being tickled and I was being mean to her. Happily my boss had my back. Edit. This happened over a decade ago. I don't work with that woman. Or for that company. In fact, even the company doesn't exist anymore. I'm also a woman. The coworker was very young and immature. This was her first job, her first time in a professional environment, and she really had no clue about professional workplace behavior. I wasn't upset, because she truly thought she was being friendly, but I still don't like being tickled. I told my sister in a PM that it's first not one RST, after she posted something on Facebook with the spelling error. She flipped out saying how I'm a bully, and I need to appreciate that her spelling is more unique. Edit, she's 27. I managed a small new team that had no procedures or policies, so I set about instituting some. I mean, you never know, I could get hit by a bus tomorrow, and then no one would know how to process these requests. I told them, when asking for their feedback, and for them to write up how they did their tasks. Then we would come back together, and decide best practices in a meeting. Little man filed a complaint to the manager for my use of violent imagery, and said that he felt threatened. It was a whole thing. Ultimately, he got fired. Fuck him. By EEE. Edit. Well, this blew up, lol. For clarity, he didn't get fired for this one incident. He was a horrible employee with real issues having a woman in charge. My parents are abusive, and have called my sisters and I every name in the book. Pretty sure cuckoo was said to me more than my name. In a fight, my sister called my dad a fool when he was throwing a hissy fit. He flipped his shit and couldn't fathom being called something more offensive. He called me and told me what she said, and I laughed at him. Now my sister and I laugh all the time about how crazy our parents are. This guy at a Halloween party I was at was dressed in a giant bacon costume. Some girl was yelling at him for being so offensive toward Jews and Muslims. She was neither Jewish nor Muslim. One of the Muslim guys at the party asked her what the frick she was talking about, but she didn't back down. Lol, I have no idea why people feel they need to go out of their way to be inaccurately offended on behalf of other cultures slash religions. Reminds me of a news story I saw a while ago. A Muslim family moved to a mostly white town. The white people decided it would help them feel more welcome if they removed every book from the library that had anything to do with pigs or bacon. I guess, just because you can't eat it, you shouldn't see it, or read about it either. When I was a child, my mum paid for something with a check. The cashier remarked that my mum had nice handwriting. My mum flew off the handle, and we had to storm out of the shop in outrage. To this day, I have no idea what happened. Maybe it brought up sore feelings from when she failed the doctor in trans exams. One time someone got offended when I put on my seatbelt, thought I was commenting on her ability to drive. Same thing happened to me. The Uber driver said, "Do you wear your seatbelt when you're with your dad?" I said yes. A sandwich. I kid you not. My ex-husband was given a sandwich by our then 13 years old daughter, and because she cut the sandwich he went off on a massive strop about how his sandwiches should never be cut, etc. The poor kid's face, she was crushed. It still winds me up no end every time I think about it. I can't believe things didn't work out between you two. He seems lovely. This is within a year after the DADT repeal. Part of the repeal was that, obviously, you can't make fun of people for their sexual preference, so calling people gay was out. Was getting directions to a coworker's house. He lived on Gay Street. Our supervisor got belligerent about how we can't say that, even after explaining how it was the street name. I love that his takeaway from don't make fun of people for being gay was, don't even say the word gay. That's some Michael Scott shit. I have a relative who's named Gay. Trying to explain to people at the height of that's gay, that my relative is actually named Gay, so when I say her name is Gay, I wasn't insulting, her name was borderline impossible. Her name's Gay. Dude, that's offensive. Meanwhile, with gay people, her name is Gay. That's amazing. Maybe 22 years ago, I had a phone interview with a baking company. I didn't care to have my peers know what I was up to, so I took the call on my cell phone in my car. The call was crystal clear, and no technical issues. At one point, they had mentioned the weather, and asked how it was where I was. I told him that I was sitting in my car and I could see that it was actively snowing and whatnot. The interviewer asked me, "Are you taking this call on a cell phone?" I told him I was. Then he asked me if I thought that was appropriate. I asked him what he meant by that. He said he thought it was kind of rude to take a formal call on a cell phone. I told him I would be more than happy to conclude the interview if talking on a cell phone was an issue. If he was interested, I'd be happy to continue it the next day when I'd be at a desk. He again repeated how rude he thought it was that I had called from a cell phone and that there was no need to continue the interview process. I disagreed with the first point, but did agree with the second. To this day, I wonder what the hell he was talking about, and where he was coming from. Wow, way to stamp I'm an aging worker who refuses to keep up with technology on his forehead. Only thing I can guess is the possibility of a dropped call, but like you said, it was completely clear. Probably just got over the fact that telephones exist, and wasn't ready to accept the fact that mobile phones aren't a thing made by the devil. Using a walking stick. I was in a car accident a few years ago and it effed my leg up. Since then I've been using a walking stick. I was walking to shop, pre-pandemic, and an old bloke gave me the dirtiest look I've ever seen. "What do you need a cane for? You're only a kid." He actually got quite pissy just seeing me using a stick. Like, "My dude, I'm just out trying to buy some milk, I don't need your shit today." I didn't say that out loud, I just said it to myself, after I got home. It's specific to France. In French we have a way to address for a man, monsieur, a married woman, madame, an unmarried woman, mademoiselle, and we used to have one for an unmarried man, mon damoiseau, which disappeared from official paperworks, since I don't even know when. In the name of gender equality, Mademoiselle was also removed a few years ago from official paperwork. Also in the name of gender equality, some employees were told to not call young women Mademoiselle anymore and to go with Madam. So the trick is, some women will get offended when called Madam, because it makes them feel old, and some women will get offended when called Mademoiselle because it's sexist. Clerks are doomed. Edit. Apparently it's not specific to the French language. I worked at a restaurant, and we put up some Halloween decorations. We had to take them all down when someone found the glittery skull decoration offensive. Similar situation happened to me. I'm a nurse at a children's hospital. I was wearing Mickey Mouse Halloween scrubs which have little dancing skeletons on it. A visitor for one of my patients complained that I was wearing scary and inappropriate scrubs. I think the best part about that being scary is we all literally have skeletons inside of us right now. Edit. Thank you for doing what you do, by the way. I once listened to my boss try to lecture the fire marshal, because he was talking about something being flame retardant. Her reasoning was you should just call it fireproof, because retardant was an awful word. It was one of those times where I really should have tried to stop her, but instead I just stood off to the side, probably making a surprised Pikachu face. I got an angry call from a client at the vet hospital I used to work at. She was angry that the doctor had written in her dog's chart something along the lines of chemotherapy has retarded the growth of the tumor. She was deeply offended that the vet called her dog retarded. Mom, your dog isn't retarded, you are. Had someone get offended by me calling my brother bro. They insisted that I was racist, and that white people can't be related to Mexicans. Like, seriously lady, that's not how genetics work. We are 100% related, and are a mix of white and Native American. It's not that unheard of for one biological sibling to come out lighter or darker than the other. And even if we weren't related, seriously? I'm racist for calling someone close to me my bro despite being different skin tones? Seriously? Thank you for coming to my rant session. Have a good day. I had someone scoff and ask me how I, a white person, have a Latina cousin. It's like they don't realize two people of different races can have kids together. My sister and I look about as much alike as Thor and Loki. Same parents. We just scored really different genes. Teachers didn't believe us when we told them we were sisters. Genetics are weird sometimes, sorry. While working tech support back during the dot-com boom, I had a customer get upset with me over the use of the word icon. He said it had religious implications and he insisted I call Windows icons little picture things. You just reminded me of the time a woman yelled at me that she'd never buy a shirt that says Moab on it, because in the Bible Moab was apparently a terrible sinful place. I was in Moab, Utah for anyone unfamiliar. I ended up just standing there blinking at her, until she finally wandered away because 1. I couldn't figure out why she was even there then. 2. I had nothing to do with the store we were in. 3. Literally no one asked her if she wanted one. And 4. I wanted nothing to do with the interaction that was occurring. Off topic, but this reminds me of my 4-year-old niece who calls commercials skip ads. Editing to add that all these upvotes and awards have made my niece feel so special. She doesn't have any clue what 15,000 upvotes means, or what Reddit is, but she's running around in absolute delight that so many people think she's funny. I've been reading most of these comments to her,